Qui-Gon.
Yeah.
Qui-Gon, say something. Say something again, Qui-Gon. That's what.
Check 1 2, check 1 2.
Streaming. First match. First match is gonna be. I don't even know what teams. Wrath against DB1. I think this is their. Is this their first match since they lost?
Yeah. Wrath?
Yeah, alright. Hopefully we don't see another fucking choke again. There's Wrath against DB1. DB1 has keys. I don't even feel like it now. Keys,
White Jedi.
Yeah.
Sorrows, Seth Nightblood.
Sorrows is on that team?
Yeah.
Oh, shit.
And then for Wrath, we have Bonnie Dinosaur, the sub, X whatever, Glam Boy, or Mock. Symphonic is how I know. Wrath winning this 2-0. Best of three, right?
Yeah, losers. Best of three. Colossus, Wrath, Dub. I have to agree with you there, Colossus. Who's commentating? Me and Qui-Gon. Nobody else is on right now. Casual's playing God. Alpha's fucking participating in the riots in Minnesota.
Yeah. So yeah, I mean, DB1's a pretty good team, but Wrath is just a little too strong for them to pull any kind of upset here.
I don't know. I feel like Wrath is a powerhouse team.
Yeah.
I know they lost, but...
they just made mistakes.
Yeah. So I have them in my top three.
I could see them beating, or beating them in another matchup. So here it's G Pooey, aka Good Poo, and Qui-Gon G here will be commentating Wrath vs. DB1, aka Down by One. This is the loser's bracket. This is Wrath's first game back since losing that match against RACP.
Yeah, Colossus, if you're not on their team, if you're not on their roster, you can commentate. Let me just check right now. If you're not, you can commentate. Just get on.
Yeah, Loonster, White Jedi, it's whatever. Colossus, what's up, guys? Waffles, what's up? Yoshir, what's happening? Girly Gamer, hey. Yeah, what are you guys up to, man? I just got back from the barber, and I got some food. I'm really trying to eat it as we're starting this, so I'm like all over the place right now. Forgive me. So yes, definitely hope Colossus can come on here and help out, because oof, I'm hungry. I haven't eaten all day, and I really would like to eat something.
Bro, I haven't eaten all day, and I've been awake since like 7 last night.
What?
Yeah.
7 p.m. last night?
Yeah. I mean, I've been doing midterms and quizzes, like essays on it.
Wow. Wow.
Wow.
Wow.
Now hold the phone.
Now,
everybody...
Guys. Everybody in the chat, I need you guys to give a round of applause for G Pooey, all the sacrifice he's been making for, you know, watching hand cams, being here to make this happen. If he wasn't here, I probably wouldn't be streaming this. And,
Yep. Oh, that's right.
And,
now, Qui-Gon,
he
how
definitely
many viewers
has
have
been holding the phone. Yep. Yep. 8 years, gamer.
No, I've been playing console for 8 years. Oh, shit, I forgot. I'm gonna invite you. I don't think I have Colossus added. Might have to suggest him.
Bro, Lunster, my freaking... this guy, this is like the third, fourth time he's done my hair. I told him 3 times today to fix it. Still got it wrong. I was just like, okay, looks great. I want to get the fuck out of here already. But, I don't know how you do that for a profession and mess up so badly on such a simple haircut. For real, it's such an easy haircut. I could do it.
I mean, what do you get?
Just like a, taper with like, almost like tapering up for like a faux hawk kind of look, but like really short. So
uh-huh.
It's nothing extravagant, you know what I mean? It's like a normal ass haircut. And dude like gets like these long spots in the spots where I told him that it grows long there, so I want it a little extra short.
Hold up. I'm gonna get Colossus in here. Colossus, you have to join the party, otherwise you can't commentate. I respect it.
Bro. It sucks because that barbershop is the only one close to my house, and it's like literally right across the street. So it's hard to like not go back. Nah, it's not Supercuts. It's called Prime Barbershop. It's like a independent. These dudes. There's like six of them in there. I've gotten a cut from pretty much everyone. The one dude did it like perfect one time, and then I haven't seen him since.
Pretty sure nobody wants to cut you.
Probably. No, I hit it off with this dude. That's what sucks, because I'm real cool with them. We have good conversations. But,
Colossus, join the party. Otherwise, you can't commentate. I did invite him. Unless I invited, I'm pretty sure I invited him. Clayton, what'd you get to eat?
I got Sonic. I got one of their Super Sonic double cheeseburgers, and then there was, well, Sonic also is right across the street from my house, and I have the app, and they give you like deals. One of the deals was popcorn chicken for 99 cents. But this ain't no popcorn chicken. It's little. Everybody's messing up today, man. I don't know what it is.
Map. It is. Power Station. Rebels pick Power Station.
What the frick?
Did they kick you?
Did I not invite you? Time's ended. Fuck.
Rip.
Was on there.
Oh, you hear the music?
Oh!
Who chose this map?
Raph chose this map.
Yes!
I would have figured that Keys would have chosen, because the way I see it, if I'm going to play a team that I know is better than me, I want to play it on a map like this where we might have some sort of chance. But I guess Raph's trolling, I don't know. They like this map. I don't know.
Maybe they're trying it out since they know DB1's not as strong as the team as any other.
Get some practice, huh?
Yeah. You gotta give this music, though. The music is fucking good.
We can't hear the music in the stream.
What are you talking about, bro? I hear it on my headphones.
Oh, yeah. Okay. I'm gonna be delayed, so I'm just gonna mute myself. Let's see. I can probably commentate if... let's see. Qui-Gon, can you...
If Qui-Gon share plays.
Share plays, yep, exactly. Probably share play and then I can handle him.
Yeah, you could share play Qui-Gon and give him the control so he can control the camera.
Yep. Probably work that out.
So we have... How do you do this?
You want to do play-by-play, Colossus?
I haven't done it in a while. But
just do it.
Sure. He's using the shield cycler. Or Charles using scan nade. Nightblood using cooling cell. I think that was DL44. We have White Jedi using Stinger and Ion Nade. Unicorn using scan and cycler. Bonnie using.
Wow, Unicorn with three picks off the bat.
And they're getting a first pull.
They got wiped.
Oh, Bonnie with the DT-29.
Falcon, you wanna relinquish control?
Yeah, let me see. How do I do that?
I don't remember. Yeah, I know it's doable though.
Oh, they're hiding in their base. Look at Nightblood. Oh, Nightblood.
Give controller to visitor. Alright. Yeah, there we go.
This feels weird. I'm gonna fuck with your set.
Alright. Plus is a little bit of a play.
Yeah, I'll look. Gunfight in the Wrath space right now. Looks like DB1's trying to push in. got two on Wrath defense. DB is right on it. They should be able to grab it here, but Wrath actually putting up a defense. Unicorn got it one pick. White Jedi takes down Unicorn, sub takes down Seth. Bonnie takes down Keys. Bonnie and X, whatever, pushing into... Actually, no, they're coming back to reinforce their team in their base to make sure they can't get a grab. We got a gunfire right in the Wrath base, and so far DB1 has control. Let's see if they're able to actually keep it. Getting out is not going to be that easy. Now, Wrath is definitely going to be getting DB1's cargo here. Actually. Is your being pretty well? Not sure.
I can hear you. Yeah. Can you hear my PS4 in the back?
Yeah.
Is it loud?
Alright, Unicorn kind of. Yeah, it is. Sub has one pick on White Jedi. We have one cargo delivery from Wrath, 6-4.
Wrath is gonna get another 4 right now. It's gonna be 7-3.
Straight to the middle. I don't see anybody expecting them. No, they have complete control over that. ODB1 is being held up in their base, not able to leave. Wrath has control over mid. Bonnie is mid. Bonnie gets taken out by White Jedi. We have somebody flanking on the side. It is Seth. Seth's flanking on the side. He should be able to get it. Nobody has seen him from Wrath. Never mind. Bonnie sees him. But Bonnie gets taken down. Unicorn's waiting for him. Unicorn takes him out with a cycler, and we see Wrath pushing in. Three men push through mid.
Yeah, it is the first map.
Alright, so we have all of Wrath in mid. They're doing a 4-man push right now. They're completely dominating in terms of current scoreboard. The only exception is Bonnie, but even then, the rest of Wrath seems to be definitely having the lead in terms of the gunfights. Right now, DB1 is completely held up in their base. Wrath is trying to push in to get another claim. Another pull, rather. Sub runs in with the shield. He should be able to get this pull. Alright, he got it. He's going through Unicorn. He's going to give him some defense, but he's going to find some DB1 in the way. Two members of DB1 were waiting for him, but Wrath came quickly enough to support him and was able to get that through. There's still two more members of DB1 on the way to Wrath base in order to try to prevent this pull. Have a gunfight in the Wrath base. X whatever holding back two people. He gets a double kill and is successful in defending his base. It's definitely going to allow for another point delivery. DB1 again. If they're just being definitely pushed back. I mean, we just need to see them try to go for a push. Otherwise, they're not going to be able to get any points. Right now, they're just being completely suppressed by the Wrath offensive. They need to be able to pull in or try to at least flank around just to try to get some grabs. I'm seeing anything on the stream. Stream, can you hear me real? You do it, just verifying.
Yeah, they should be able to hear you.
Alright, we got Wrath pushing in to mid. We got a flank going on? Okay, yeah. I'm seeing one person DB here. Where is he? Okay, we see three in the DB base. There is someone flanking, and it is Soros. I was trying to push into the Wrath base. Typically, be successful. Saros able to sneak around. He's gonna get it, but he's gonna have to deal with X whatever once he's able to grab it. Or is he gonna wait? It seems like he's trying to go for the waiting game. See if maybe Wrath is gonna try to get a pull and he can stop it. Interesting play. It might work for kind of like a counter defense here. But oh, they know he's there. So now he's gonna have to deal with two Wrath members. He's getting pushed back. So whatever gets killed. Unicorn going 20 and 10. One thing to note. See, what do we got? What do we got? So, back in the DB1 base, they're all out here in defense. We got three man defense. Saro's trying to push into mid, but he's gonna be met with three people from Wrath. He's gonna go take him down. Saro's is getting to be one. He's gonna get cut down. Alright, he's out. We got one person, Keys, pushing in, trying to flank around to the Wrath base, but Sub knows he's going that way. They're trying to go in for an intercept. He's, let's see if he can actually make it. Meanwhile, we still have a three-man defense on the DB1 base. I feel like they need to be a bit more aggressive, otherwise they're not going to be able to do much. I mean, I get it, they're not really winning their gunfight, but they have to try to figure out a way to push out. Because right now, they are definitely not going to be able to make a change if they just stay in their base. Now, Keys have tried to flank, got double-teamed by... appeared to be X, whatever, and stuff, I want to say.
Do you guys know if Keys has been scrimming at all? Because he's really struggling right now. He was going, he's going like, what, 7-15? And I remember at the end of the drop zone tournament, he was playing really well.
Yeah, I think so, he just stopped scrimming. I think mostly he plays Apex now.
He's someone I would expect to carry this team, but he's bottom of the scoreboard right now.
I mean, I don't know, but I will agree with the fact that as far as gunfights right now, he's...
it is a 3v4 now, so...
oh, they might have a chance here.
Yeah.
X whatever did say he was probably going to lag out. So they may actually have a chance here. They're going to have to capitalize and use these 6 minutes to their advantage. They need to get rid of this 3-point lead as fast as they can. They have the numbers game, so they need to be able to pull up that gun skill and not be overwhelmed by Wrath. They can make it. They can definitely get this comeback. They have 6 minutes. That's plenty of time to bring the cargo from one side to another. Enough times for them to win. It's doable. They just gotta push through. They cannot be playing defensive right now. They cannot. I see two people holding defense. That is not what you want to see.
Having three players on your team almost makes it mandatory to play all defense.
Yeah. I don't know why. Yeah, exactly. We should all be seeing a massive push from DB1 right now, and I don't see that fully happening. Keys is gonna go try to fight Unicorn. I don't think this is gonna go too well. Oh, but he gets him!
Oh, Keys!
Cuts him down! Alright.
That's the Keys we know right there.
Yeah, that was a great fight. Alright, here we go. DB1 is trying to go on the offensive. This is what they need to do. They have 5 minutes. They can definitely do this. They need to push. They cannot be reserved in their approach. They gotta move in. Wrath is holding two-man defense and then one person trying to push out. It appears to be Unicorn. Unicorn, I can't tell if he's either trying to push or just run interference in mid. He got hit by a proximity. Might be still alive. Unicorn seems to be flanking around while Jedi is in mid. Wrath is just holding the base down with two people in two separate positions. Good positioning in terms of the Wrath defense right now. Let's see if they're able to hold it. Bonnie's able to kind of definitely watch Sub's back there. Sub was about to get flanked and Bonnie was able to cover him while Sub is engaging two other enemies in the front. Unicorn gets one pick on Saros.
If you're a DB1, I think they need to push in duos together, because they're not winning gunfights.
Yeah, but they should be able to win 2v1 gunfights, so again, we need to see this push.
Get a spawn.
X, whatever the chat says, I knew that would happen.
We do have two from DB1 here. He's about to pick up the cargo. Where is he? He's waiting to get the kill, but wasn't able to get it. Saros gets the kill. Bonnie Dinosaur meets him out there.
Bonnie's able to get the punish spawn, so he's gonna get it to be one now. Probably gonna get pushed and killed. Oh, Saros gets a pick, though. If Saros is able to... it's gonna be hard, but he can make it, maybe. He does get the punish spawn. Sub needs to give a... oh, Sub's pushing to be one. Let's see, will we have it? Bonnie's coming back to reinforce him. Bonnie's able to get White Jedi now to 1v1 versus White Saros and Bonnie. Bonnie has a DH, he gets the pick. We see Seth pushing, but he's not aware that the unicorn's behind him. He gets cut off by Unicorn, White Jedi, and was it Anseros going in from the side, trying to flank. Sub is waiting for White Jedi, so White Jedi's probably gonna get cut down here. And she does. We see a four-man push through mid. We need this. Keith is a bit lagging behind him to push forward. Oh, Seth gets a nice kill, but he gets taken down by... Oh, yeah. Yeah, two-man push on the left side. Wrath base. White Jedi and Cyrus pushing in. Cyrus gets taken down. White Jedi gets a kill. Unicorn pushing on White Jedi. White Jedi takes down Unicorn. White Jedi is now in Wrath base. Could push, but she's going to get flanked by Sub. Sub gets a kill. Wrath still has control over the base. They are honestly not capitalizing on this opportunity. Like, they are playing a 4v3. They need to push it in two-man groups and be able to get these kills and get control of their base. I want to say that this is due to Wrath practicing on this map very often, that they are able to hold down this defense very efficiently. Or it could be due to the fact that if we look at scoreboards, the gun skill is definitely going to Wrath. Those could be two individually contributing factors, but,
I noticed DB1's missing a lot of shots. Like, they get him one shot, and they miss, like, five shots. Yeah. Unable to secure the kill.
Oh, I mean, this... Alright, so here we go. Seth is pushing from the side, but he's pushing by himself. You know, this situation where I would immediately ask my partner, hey, you know, if you're far away and I'm about to push in, restart on me, be able to get a two-man push, do not push it by yourself.
The thing is,
you're not going to be able to make it.
They're going in pairs, and they keep getting cleared, and they keep respawning all the way in the back. Yeah. See, now they got to wait for Keys and Nightblood to make it all the way back.
Yeah. Okay. I mean, this is also a very close range map, so it's quite easy to reinforce the people on your team. It's quite easy to team shot if you play it carefully, if you know your positioning. And I feel like Wrath is taking advantage of that, especially in the defense game as far as team shotting. Jedi's trying to rush in for a mad dash, but no, that's not gonna happen. Who was running shield on DB1's team?
It's Keys.
Keys? Okay. I feel like I didn't see that many shield rushes towards the cargo. Maybe could have got a sneaky grab and try to push back. But... Yeah, no, this... Imperials have the cargo. That's that Unicorn dropped me on 40. Ooh. 41.
Unicorn is deadly with that cycler, man.
Yep. It has been. So, what I'm curious is now, because they lost the member, would they then continue with the 3v4 for the next match?
No. Oh, no, right? What? Oh, okay. They just pick him up for the next game.
Yeah, well, Xodor said he lagged out. I don't know if he's still good.
I mean, if he lags out and he can't get back on, then yeah, they have to continue the series.
Yeah, right. Okay, yeah. That's
but
what I was asking.
If he, like, lags out and then he could play again, he could just join.
Yeah. That's what it was. Wait, click and I forgot.
Yeah. I feel helpless. Colossus is at the helm of my PlayStation right now. Don't look at all the naked pictures I have.
Oh, no. Alpha sent them? Oh, no.
Well, most of them are good poo, but...
Uh-oh.
He looks like the guy at the bottom. Wait, go back? Yeah, he looks like that guy. Oh, yeah, the stream can't see it, damn.
Yeah, no.
Job of the
Hutt. Which guy? Yeah.
Job of the Hutt.
Wait, go to his good poo on collect. I think it's on collect.
Yeah.
There's good poo.
Look at the good poo.
It's you eating Sonic right now.
Yeah.
$1 million.
Look at the street, look at the street. You got this level 2. What do you do?
Yeah, as in. Oh, wait, what? Why is my Deoxys white? Oh, wait, okay, it's not. Okay.
Yeah. I like you're saying things.
I unlocked everything.
Do you have any funny names for your hands? Or are you just. Jeez, it's 19, man.
I know, I need to delete some. It's just like you do like a private match. Oh, we're going to play with this and make a new hand. And then.
I thought I had a decent amount of 10, but. Right, so.
Maybe you can get in here. Get in your.
Yeah,
your
that's what I'm about to. Yeah. Then Qui-Gon, you get back here.
Oh, yeah, that's right. Yeah,
Yeah. Well, I mean, I feel like you're gonna need an invite first, and then I'll use your account to invite myself. There is a bit of an input delay, though, which I did notice while I was.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, we tried doing it on Battlefront 2, and it was just so difficult to play. When the game first came out, there's so much input lag.
Send one to Qui-Gon, because I'm on his right now, and then I'll... Yeah, alright, there we go. Okay. You can take back over. I'm gonna get it down.
Share play?
Alright, here we go.
There it is. And whatever is back in business, we have a 4v4, ladies and gentlemen. Wrath versus DB1, this is map 2.
Do we know what map 2 is? Kick X. Seems like X is still having connection issues.
Rip.
Should it be telling me, sub? Message in your chat.
Yeah.
What?
Gotta talk keys.
What are we playing here, Rebel Depot?
I have no clue, that's what I was about to ask you guys. Good, but do we know the map?
Whatever, what map
is. Carbonite.
Oh, Carbonite Freezing Chambers. So I do fully expect to see at least one CA come out.
Wow.
Probably from Unicorn, if I'm honest.
Wow.
This has to be the first time in the history of Battlefront where the teams pick the two worst maps to play. Looks like, I don't know why... Well, actually, DB1, I would do the same thing, honestly, knowing that...
You think so?
On a normal map... We kind of don't stand a chance, so let's try a map that's really...
Unorthodox, unusual, yeah. But, I mean, it's a very risky strategy, right? So if you're DB and you're taking an unplayed map, you need to put your own hours into it. Because even though it's a map that Wrath may not play all the time, you can't expect to just be able to walk in and take an easy victory. But, I mean, if they practice and if they know what they're doing, we could see... something unexpected happened. But at the same time, I know for a fact Wrath has practice on this map. So,
yeah.
We'll see. I also expect to see a CA from Unicorn, which last time we saw that in Carbonite, I think in a tournament, was about 40-plus kills. So let's see what happens this time.
Yeah, I mean, they lost a 4v3, so they need something miraculous here.
Yeah.
To help them out. And maybe playing on a funky map like Carbonite might give them a little bit of an edge. But
hey, I mean, the thing about Carbonite is if you get the right kills and you force the other team back into their spawn point, you can definitely get a good delivery for a cargo.
King Xerius is 1-0. Wrath is up. It's best out of 3. So winner, if Wrath wins this one, they'll take this match. And
good
put.
You
want to
go through the hands?
The hands should be the same. Yeah, hands should be the same. Oh, we have
well,
Jedi.
Well, Jedi's running
yeah.
Trip Mine, Stinger, and Ion Nade with Scout. This Key's running. Key's got a Cycler Shield and Survivalist. Sorrows has Cooling Cell, Thermal Death, and Survivalist. Seth Nightblood has Scamp Pulse, Deoxys.
Right.
So we're gonna restart.
We're gonna be doing a rehost, it looks like.
Oh.
Yes, choose an X whatever lag out. Not surprising.
Who is this? Seth Nightblood still playing like he's looking for someone?
I wonder if they've figured it out. Well, all four of them are still playing. They haven't in the lobby. There we go. No, it's out. But so as far as the laser trip mine. Which is one thing I noticed, very good for this map, I think. In this map, it's very easy to hide and just kind of surprise people. So laser trip mine definitely adds to that ability, kind of be stealth in your approach. So it is a good, I would argue it is very good for a base defense on this map.
Yeah, definitely. Even on offense, I ran it on offense, and when I would run down a hall, I'd put it on a like where they would be coming behind me. I've gotten kills that way where they're following right behind me and they just die to the trip mine.
And even if they don't, you are forcing them to kind of pause for a moment and lose valuable time in trying to catch up to you.
Yep.
So, I mean,
yeah, I think Rebel Base and this map are really good for laser trip mine. Or is it Rebel Base? No, it's Imperial
Carbonite
Base.
Freezing Chambers, you mean?
No,
or
the
you
other
mean
map,
the side.
What's it called? The one with the long haul. What's that? What
station?
Station, yeah.
Imperial Station. Yeah, that one's good for...
Well, Darkness asked who won the first map. It was Wrath.
Yep, Wrath was up
8-0.
8-2.
Yeah, I mean, 8-2, yeah.
With like 9 minutes left, and one of their members lagged out. So it was a
4v3. Yeah,
but
it was a 4v3 for the last 6 minutes of it.
Yeah, the DB1 couldn't score at all.
Yeah. Now, this is close quarters engagements, especially in all the hallways, so you need fast reaction time in your gunplay. DB, if you're fighting the close range, you don't even need that much extreme accuracy. You just got to be able to react fast enough, especially in close range. I mean, maybe that's one way that they'll be able to gain a bit of an upper hand as far as gunfights go. I'm just thinking of, you know, ways that DB might be able to kind of claim a bit of an upper hand, especially when looking back at the previous match where we really didn't see that. Could also be given, you know, that the last map was also close range and they were not able to do it, but, you know. Well, I like to think that there's a reason why DB decided to go with Carbonite Freezing Chambers instead of a more usual pick as far as map choices. Just whatever says my internet sucks.
I mean,
we know.
If you're losing a 4v3, you want to give yourself some sort of chance because they know on any given map, Wrath knows all the maps, how to play them really well. And maybe Wrath doesn't know this map as well as the other ones. Taking away some of the advantage because they know that Wrath has probably some of the best IQ as far as cargo goes as any team in the tournament. So,
yeah.
Any little bit of
advantage they can get, yeah.
Or taking away from the advantage that Wrath already has, maybe to help them.
Definitely. I do agree with that. You definitely want to be able to take any bit of, essentially, you know, hold that you can against an opponent that you know historically you will perform really well. Let's see if it pays out. Right.
So, X whatever is running Stinger, Deoxys, Survivalist. The sub has Ion Nade, Shield, Survivalist, Unicorn with
CA87. As expected.
Series 7, yeah, with the thermal detonator and scamp holes. No cycler. And Bonnie has cycler instead, and he's got the DT-29.
I mean, Unicorn's already running the cycler, it's called the CA.
Right.
I realize he's gonna win this gunfight. Oh, Sub barely gets that gunfight, but to be fair, he is pushing strongly with the rest of the Wrath team. We see a three-man push right now. Were they doing a full push? They were. So they were doing a full four-man push. And I think Unicorn's out here getting picks, isn't he? All right. And yep, he got two. Just got taken down. Sub is pushing in with the rest of Wrath.
Oh, Keys gets Bonnie out of the air with Cycler.
Nice.
And excuse me, Bonnie's actually using DL-44, not DT-29.
DL-44, interesting pick, but very effective at close range. Especially in his very like tight hallways. And we have a pickup from Rat. Sub's gonna be taking it through the tunnels in the first ground level. He's going
White
in with
Jedi,
he's going
with being smart, yeah. Get to their base right away.
We're seeing three members of DB1 getting to their base, trying to stop Wrath from getting this delivery. X, whatever, is stuck in a gunfight. He gets one pick. DB1 needs to help them out here. They're being swept away. We see X, whatever, get Seth Knight. And now we're seeing Sub running in with the shield. He will be able to get this point. And Sub also is able to get a nice turn on White Jedi.
Ooh, Keys hits Sub with the cycler there. Clear him off the base.
Keys is definitely doing much better this round. Absolutely. I mean, in the last game, Keys was off the leaderboard. Right now, he is on top of his team with 5 kills. Saru's being second in that with only 1. So I think Keys is definitely performing a lot
Ooh.
Better.
Bonnie hits a nice cycler on Saru as he tries to jetpack away. He's going to be pushing their base a little bit. X whatever picks up kill on Keys.
X whatever pushing on Saros, but it gets taken out by Unicorn on the side. That nasty shotgun shot. Alright, what do we got in the DB1 base? We see why Jedi playing defense in their base. Interesting placement. But Energy has other members that are help her out. I think I smell one person sneaking in. Yep, Unicorn is hiding down here in their base with a CA. Very, very sneaky. They haven't found him yet. They know they're there now. Seems like Unicorn is just sneaking in and then giving partner response to Sup, who then grabs and runs away, and Unicorn provides a bit of an escort. That's what it's looking like right now. Unicorn just taking it, running straight. Seth right behind him. Sup needs to do something about Seth or he's going to get taken down. And he does. He turns around and takes down Seth.
Interesting that White Jedi didn't follow.
I don't think following would have necessarily been effective, but I would have definitely tried to go for some sort of an intercept, which I didn't see. And also, if you look at Wrath's movement, they know exactly where to be to support their members. They actually seem to know this map perfectly well, as far as where they need to be and how long it's going to take them. One thing I noticed there was that Sub took it one route, and Unicorn was able to meet him perfectly. Right before going back into the base. Perfect timing. That might have been coincidence or luck, or Wrath may actually have very good control over this map as far as how to play it and how to move in it. Sup gets a pick on Saros, where did I get to pick on next, whatever. We are seeing another four-man push. So one thing I find interesting from Wrath is that they seem to be doing entire four-man pushes. They're not leaving anybody on defense. They're being very aggressive. Now, what I'd like to see from DB1 is them being able to get counter-pulls. Seeing as Wrath is going a very aggressive route, they should be able to get the Wrath cargo and at least try to be able to contest that way. And there we go, we saw it. They were able to get one of them picked up, but Sup now has theirs. So let's see if he's gonna be able to deliver this. I'm more curious to see. No, Bonnie's able to get him down. And he gets a return. Very good return. Yeah, no. Wrath definitely knows how to play this map. They may not participate in scrims has frequently in it, but they certainly have taken their time to see which routes are the most ideal to get a quick victory. We might be seeing a 10-0. If we're looking at time and current score, it's pretty likely.
Yeah.
But one thing I will definitely point out, from DB1, Keys definitely has turned it up.
Yeah, having double the kills of any other player on his team.
Yep, absolutely. Keys should be able to get a pull here. Gives opponent a spawn. Death isn't aware of it yet.
Cargo is in our possession. Defend it.
So that's interesting. So X Whatever is playing specifically mid. So X Whatever is sitting at the placement where he would be able to give support to his team and also stop a cargo delivery. Unicorn gets a double. Nope, he's getting taken out by Soros. Sub barely is able to get that, but beautiful. He's able to roll into mid, and it being one shot, lands one final shot on Soros and is able to get the return. And now he's also going to get the cargo in. Wajeda needs to get this return. No.
This will soon be over. Commandeer, one more cargo.
Wajeda is able to kill Sub before he delivers, almost on the cargo, but isn't able to return. Unfortunately, we're now going 9-1. Rav having the lead. Jedi trying to push in through mid, but gets taken down by the Sub. We see another two-man flank, who I'm gonna assume is Keys with somebody else. It's Keys on Saros, trying to push on the side, but Wrath knows that they're coming that way. But Keys gets a nice cycle on Bonnie, who's trying to cycle him in return. And we're seeing X-Whatever trying to push in, but he should be getting shot in the back by someone. Bonnie gets Saros. Keys is having this gunfight here against Bonnie. Cycler's out. Who's gonna get it?
I think Saros pulled out an E4. Jedi with a pulse cannon.
I did hear an E4, I wasn't sure about it.
Jedi just pulled out a pulse cannon.
Jedi pulling out a pulse cannon.
Yeah, Saros has adrenaline stem, E4. And he still loses the gunfight to Bonnie.
Now, I don't want to be too biased here, but that was very sad to see.
Yeah.
Well, this is obviously... I mean, if it wasn't obvious before, it is now. This is a win for Ref. See, has, DB1 has dropped the rules and doesn't seem to care. So, might as well just give the 10 out of Wrath at this point.
Yeah.
Wonder if Saros is going to be able to go not triple negative after taking out his E3. I mean, his EE4. White Jedi misses with the pulse cannon and gets emoted by Sup. I see no issue with this.
He has adrenaline stem with factors, still can't stay alive.
X Whatever getting a nice double kill.
Our cargo has been returned.
Alright, so we have DB1 here. One person with the pulse cannon, another one with an EE4 and Bacta. That one with an EE4 and Bacta going 5-17. Keys gets a nice kill.
He's holding his competitive integrity and hasn't changed his hand.
And is still dominating in his team by a lot. And he's trying to get a cargo in. He's taking it with him. Saros is in front of it, but he has an E4, so what do I care about him? Saros running it back, though. I don't know why he seems to be trying. It's not like he can win.
We have taken the cargo back.
Talk to me. What's happening?
Well, what's happening is looks like Unicorn's gonna take him out.
Looks like Unicorn
He's
just walks in there.
He's still gonna lose that gunfight. Saros is probably raging right now.
And if we look at the Sub, just standing here with their cargo emoting. I'm fine with this.
Yeah, I think.
A Sub still gets the kill on Soros with a... Oh, wow. That is just... That's just sad. Soros going 7-19 with an E4. Sub gets a nice cyclone on someone. Keyes is in a gunfight. Get taken down. And oh my god, the sub. Disgusting set of kills. He gets a triple kill. And the last player he got a kill on had an E4 and back down. White Jedi does get a nice kill on Exodor with a bow rifle. Saros is looking at a wall with his E4. He does get Bonnie. And get taken down by Unicorn CA. Unicorn CA claims another big 10 being White Jedi, but is able to get a trade. White Jedi with the bow rifle. Keys still withholding his integrity. Despite the rest of his team not doing a very good job of it. I will point out, Seth Nightblood is still following all the rules. I think it's time for us to simply get this last point and get this over with. I think we're about to see that. Alright, so Unicorn gets a pickup. What is going on? Well, it appears that two people on DB1 don't care about the rules. But I will point out they're not doing too good. So, yeah, well, this is sad. Let's just see Wrath finish this delivery. Get this over with. No, Keys is pushing in. Gets taken down, though. Nope, he ain't gonna make it.
She just bow rifled that air right there. Oh,
it seems that Saros has realized that he can now get kills with the EE4. He's now switched to an EE3.
But yeah, DB1, they're down 9-1. They got mad. Bird pulling out EE4, back to adrenaline stand, bow rifle, pulse cannon.
Yep. Alright, well, that's all there is to it. Love's the kind of turning, I agree. Saros out here showing his prime skill. And with that in mind, I'm just gonna call it because it is what it is. So Wrath takes the win. 2-0. Wrath moves on. DB1 is out. Zeros showing exceptional gun skill with his EE3 and EE4. Still going double negative. Getting completely trashed by Wrath, who I think is now going to go full CA, because why not? And it won't really matter, because that's that. Now, I don't think Rash will be penalized for taking the CA approach, will they? Good for
no, because no. Their team already fucked off. Okay. So they're just making it fun at this point.
Yep, and they're demolishing them. Who's winning? Well, who's winning isn't the right term. I'd say who won. So, Wrath won. 9... Well, fuck it. Wrath won 10-0 on this one. Especially after DB1 decided to break the rules, take out EE4's back to pulse cannons, and still go very, very much negative. In the first match, it was on one of the Death Star maps, and DB had the opportunity to beat Wrath when they lost one member. It was 3-4 in the last 6 minutes, and DB was not able to capitalize on that opportunity. Wrath still won 8-2, and in this one, it was far, far worse. Wrath dominating a 9-1 game for most of it, and then DB1 pulls out EE4 backed up. Pulse cannon, just completely abandoning any sort of competitiveness to it. Clearly accepting the fact that they have lost. I would have liked to see a bit better sportsmanship in the sense that they wouldn't have broken the rules. It wouldn't have changed anything based on what we were seeing. But yeah, kind of sad that that's how it ended. But complete domination from Wrath. It is what it is. Thoughts on this group, Quaggo?
Kind of went in as expected. I know Wrath is gonna rump him.
Final shout out before I head out of here. Shout out to Saros for that beautiful E4 play where he still went more than double negative. Good job, man.
Yeah. So where does that bring Wrath? Well, for one, DB1. That's the second loss. You guys lost, right? Yeah, we lost. So Wrath is going up against F2W. Yep, that's going to be a great game.
Yeah, that'll be a great game to watch. Right, everybody?
Oh, man.
Qui-Gon, Goopu, thank you all for letting me commentate today. stream. I hope I did an okay job. I haven't done this in way too long. Wrath.
Yeah.
GG. And someone, I'll be on my way out. Take care, y'all.
Someone actually said they liked your commentary in their chat, so. Good job.
Alright. I'm in the stream. I'm gonna leave the party.